Could Mars and Venus be just like Earth in the past? Mars and Venus are the two closest and most Earth-like planets in size and distance from the Sun. The most recent research has shown the existence of water on Mars, and simulations of the climatic evolution of Venus indicate that it could have also have had water in the past. Being so, were Mars and Venus planets with oceans and forests full of life like Earth millions of years ago? Let's find out. Hey guys, have you ever heard of a VPN? If not, let me explain it to you in a way that's easy to understand. Browsing the internet without a VPN is like sending a private message to a group chat. Everyone can see what you're up to. Scary, right? But don't worry, I've got just the solution for you. Introducing Private Internet Access, or PIA for short. Watching Netflix without PIA is like going to Paris as a tourist but being only allowed to see the suburbs. But with PIA, you get access to region-restricted content from all over the world. PIA is like a bodyguard for your internet connection, protecting you from the prying eyes of hackers, internet service providers, and others that can view your personal data. Plus, it's the world's most transparent VPN provider, with over 30 million downloads. PIA never records or stores user data, and its no-logs policy has been proven multiple times in court and by a third-party audit from Deloitte. It's available for all platforms, Windows, macOS, Android, Linux, iOS, and many more. You can now use one private internet access subscription to protect an unlimited amount of devices at the same time. And get this, by using the link in the description, you can grab an 83% discount on private internet access. That's just $2.03 a month, and you can also get 4 extra months completely free. Signing up for private internet access is risk-free. There's a 30-day money-back guarantee, and 24/7 customer support is available. So why not try and see it for yourself? Sign up today and protect your digital life with private internet access. In a past video, we talked about what all the planets in the solar system looked like billions of years ago. If you have not seen it, we recommend it. In that video, we mentioned that in the past, Mars and Venus may have been very similar to Earth. But how similar? Could they have had all the necessary conditions to house living beings? Let's start with Venus. Billions of years ago, after the planets finished forming, they were very different from how they are today. Earth was not the paradise we know. Mars was not that cold, and Venus was not that hot. In the case of Venus, it is possible that after it passed the late bombardment period, it maintained stable temperatures and hosted liquid water for billions of years before an event triggered drastic changes in the planet. Venus is a lifeless planet with a toxic atmosphere 90 times thicker than ours and surface temperatures reaching 464 degrees Celsius. These temperatures are hot enough to melt lead. The scientific community often classifies Venus as Earth's twin because the two planets are similar in size, but besides that one aspect, they have nothing else in common. However, a study by scientist Michael Way of the Goddard Institute for Space Sciences compared 5 climate simulations from Venus's past. Each scenario suggested that the planet could support liquid water and a temperature climate on its surface for at least 3 billion years. Those temperatures could have included a high of 50 degrees Celsius and a low of 20 degrees Celsius, which is enough to keep liquid water in its atmosphere. But about 750 million years ago, something triggered the release of carbon dioxide from the planet's rocks, terraforming its climate, evaporating all the water, and turning it into a planet without water or life. According to Michael Way, the hypothesis is that Venus may have had a stable climate for billions of years. The near-global resurgence event may be responsible for its transformation from an Earth-like climate to the hellish greenhouse we see today. How did the idea that Venus could be like Earth come about? NASA's Pioneer mission first suggested the idea that Venus may have had oceans of water in the 1980s. But given its location as the second planet from the Sun, Venus was not considered conductive to sustaining an ocean. Venus receives more sunlight than Earth, which evaporates liquid water, sending hydrogen into space and trapping a buildup of carbon dioxide. That would lead to a continuous greenhouse effect that would create its current toxic atmosphere. Images of Venus taken by the Venera 9 probe shows that Venus's topography was entirely altered by volcanic eruptions that most likely filled lowland regions and possible ocean basins over the past billion years. Simulating the past. Many of the tools we use to model climate change on Earth can be adapted to study climates on other planets, both past and present, said Michael Way, a GISS researcher and lead author of the paper. Research on this finding was conducted as part of NASA's Planetary Astrobiology Program through the Nexus for Exoplanet System Science, NEXSS program, which searches for life on planets orbiting other stars or exoplanets, combining intuitions from the fields of astrophysics, planetary science, heliophysics, and earth sciences. Scientists have theorized that Venus formed from ingredients similar to Earth's, but followed a different evolutionary path. Of the five simulations performed, three included the current topography of Venus. They added a deep ocean of about 310 meters, a shallow ocean of about 10 meters, and traces of water on the ground. The researchers compared this to two other simulations, one using Earth's topography with a deep ocean and an ocean world. To recreate the likely conditions on Venus that occurred 4.2 billion years ago and then simulate the changes over time, scientists gradually increased solar radiation to reflect the sun as it warmed. This also changed atmospheric conditions over time. Previously, researchers believed that Venus was too close to the sun to hold liquid water on its surface, beyond the inner limit of the sun's habitable zone. The new simulations change that belief. Venus currently has almost twice the solar radiation we have on Earth. However, in all the modeled scenarios, it was discovered that Venus could still withstand surface temperatures that could retain liquid water. Simulations suggest that Venus underwent a rapid cooling phase a few billion years after its formation. Then the atmosphere would have been filled with carbon dioxide. If Venus evolved in a similar way to Earth, that carbon dioxide would have descended from the atmosphere, attracted by silicates, and would have been trapped on the surface. This would have allowed the atmosphere to be filled with nitrogen with small amounts of carbon dioxide and methane, providing stability. This would indicate that for at least 2 billion years, Venus had the necessary conditions to host liquid water, oceans, and possibly living beings. But something happened about 700 million years ago that remains a mystery, although researchers think it's related to volcanic activity. The magma released the carbon dioxide trapped in the soil and released it into the atmosphere. And when the magma cooled, the gas could not be reabsorbed on the surface and was scattered in the air. So much carbon dioxide in the atmosphere caused a runaway greenhouse effect that transformed the planet quickly and went from a paradise with oceans of water to a planet with a deadly and toxic atmosphere. Mars suffered the same fate. Like Venus, Mars has likely been like Earth. But in the case of Mars, much more substantial evidence has been found both on its surface and in its atmosphere. How was it possible for Mars to host oceans if the red planet is farther from the sun than Earth, and billions of years ago the sun generated less heat than today? This is something that keeps Timothy Lyons up at night. He is a professor of biochemistry at the University of California, Riverside, and one of the main researchers on the evolution of the atmosphere of Mars. For Mars to be warm enough to host liquid water, its atmosphere would likely have needed an immense amount of greenhouse gases, especially carbon dioxide, said UCR graduate student Chris Tino, co-author of the paper with Eva Stukin, a professor at the University of St. Andrews in Scotland. Since it is impossible to sample the atmosphere of Mars, just as it was billions of years ago, to know its carbon dioxide content, the team looked for a place on Earth whose geology and chemistry bear remarkable similarities to the Martian surface, and which could provide some of the missing pieces. This place is the crater Nordlinger Ries of southern Germany. Formed approximately 15 million years ago after being hit by a meteorite, Ries crater features some of the Earth's best-preserved rock and mineral layers. For its part, NASA's Mars rover analyzed at the beginning of 2020 an ancient crater with an identical and well-preserved structure on the red planet. Both places presented liquid water in their distant past, so comparing their chemical composition brings new and valuable information to what we already have. Although, according to Tino, it is doubtful that ancient Mars had enough oxygen to harbor complex life forms. Some microorganisms could have developed if ancient Martian water had had a neutral pH level and been highly alkaline. Those conditions involve enough carbon dioxide in the atmosphere to warm the planet and make liquid water possible, perhaps thousands of times more than Earth's atmosphere has today. The evidence is there. Unlike Venus, which it has been concluded that it was like Earth only by climatic simulations, in the case of Mars, there is physical and observable evidence that indicates the bodies of water on the planet. Today, the atmosphere of Mars is estimated to have 0.01% water in the form of vapor, and it is known that there is also water ice in the subsurface. In July of 2018, Italian researchers from the European Space Agency's ESA Mars Express mission announced the detection of an underground lake on Mars. Due to the climate of the red planet, liquid water can't be on its surface, so the only possibility is to find it locked in the subsoil. With about 20 kilometers in diameter and 1.5 kilometers deep under the Martian South Polar Ice, this lake's presence has been interpreted thanks to the veteran MARSIS radar, operational since 2005, which has been readjusted to increase its sensitivity. Andrea Cicchetti, director of operations at MARSIS, says radar sampling rates and data resolution were too low. They had to devise new software to generate more extensive sampling and improve the resolution of the data collected. "Now we see things that weren't possible before," Cicchetti said. However, it is still not easy. The mass of water detected is rich in salts, a key element to keep it in a liquid state. The salt in the water lowers the freezing point where temperatures touch 70 degrees Celsius below zero. This finding opens the door to discovering other bodies of water in other places on the planet, which in turn leads to rescuing the million-dollar question again. Is there life on Mars? If there is, it could be found in microbial form swimming in those frigid Martian waters. Everything indicates that sooner rather than later, the riddle will be solved. For many years, the red planet has been thoroughly scrutinized. The first probes to approach it did so in the 1960s. Since then, rovers and satellites of all kinds are revealing their mysteries. Until now, samples of large amounts of water in the subsurface, traces of what may have been water currents etched into the rocks and slopes of the planet's surface, as well as formations indicating the presence of ancient water currents, indicate that most likely in the past, Mars was like Earth. Vast oceans full of water covered much of the planet, a much denser and heavier atmosphere full of carbon dioxide, and large lakes flooded the entire landscape. With all these conditions, it is possible that Mars could be the cradle that gave rise to living beings at some point in history. Then the impact of a meteorite expelled that organic material, taking her to Earth. In that case, all living beings on this planet would be extraterrestrials brought by the power of meteorite impacts. This is what we know as the theory of panspermia. While there is no way to prove this, it is interesting to know that our planetary neighbors in the past may have been paradises for life, but something happened that caused them to cease to be. Today, Mars is nothing like what perhaps it was in the past. The most accepted hypotheses maintain that at some point in history, the magnetic field of the planet was weakening until slowly disappearing completely. This left the atmosphere exposed to solar radiation, which tore off the atmosphere, taking most of the water in the form of steam, and the rest was deposited under the subsoil where the radiation from the sun cannot evaporate it. Mars and Venus may have been like Earth billions of years ago, but they are no longer. Both planets are a reminder that Earth won't always be the paradise it is today. Chances are that our blue home will resemble one of these two planets in the future.